Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Sorry again, this video is going to stumble a little bit, so please cope up with that. I hope as soon as the lockdown will be over here in India, I'll go and get votes and markers. So it's easy that way. But okay, please cope up with the information here. Just try to gain as much as you can. This video is going to be about job in UAE, United Arab Emirates. And the second video which I'll upload after this in continuation will be about PG in UAE. By job, I mean you have done your MBBS from any country all around the world from a university which is recognized by WHO. There is a website, if you can check if your university comes under WHO recognized university. And the second video, which is about PG, is when you want to start your residency or when you want to continue your specialization, that is about PG. Job, you just want to get a license to work in that country. And residency or PG means you want to do your specialization and super specialization. So about the job in UAE, let's talk about UAE first because it confuses a lot of people. Now UAE is a country which has 7 states, 7 emirates: Dubai, Abu Dhabi, Sharjah, Amman. Now I'm sorry if I'm going to pronounce these names wrongly. Al Kuwain, Fuzairiyah, Ras Al Khaimah. Okay, whatever the names are, you understood the point. 7 states in the UAE. And there are 4 exams if you wish to work in any of these states. First exam is HAAD, I'm going to call it HAD. It is conducted by Abu Dhabi Health Authority. This is the exam if you wish to work in Abu Dhabi. The second one is DHA, Dubai Health Authority, conducted by Dubai Health Authority. It is if you wish to work in Dubai. The third exam is DHCC. The full form stands for Dubai Health Care City Authority exam. And the third one is MOH. Okay, we covered Abu Dhabi here, Dubai here, Dubai here. For all other remaining 5 states, that is after Amman, this, this and this. For all these 5 states, you have exam name as MOH. HAD is considered to be toughest of all the examinations. The type of questions that comes are MCQ, which we call CBT. 120 MCQ done in 2 hours. This is the first step. The second step is pencil and paper exam, which is of 150 MCQ in 3 hours. The third step is oral viva examination. They'll ask you about the clinical scenarios in 30 to 45 minutes. The last exam is OSCE, Objective Structural Clinical Examination, where you'll be given direct patients clinical cases for 45 minutes, 30 to 45 minutes, and you'll do the diagnosis and treatment of those patients. Now you can give this exams as many times as 3, no more than that. If you fail all 3 times, forget about giving this exam again. The second one is DHA, which is conducted by Dubai Health Authority. It is also conducted, you can give this exam up to 3 times. Same as HAD, some of the similarities are for the all exams. 70 MCQ in 2 hours. CBT exam, same MCQ will be given and 1 out of the 4 options will be correct. The second step is oral viva, 35 minutes. This exam has 2 steps, so it is considered easy, as well as the difficulty of the examination is far less than the HAD exam. This is considered the most toughest one. And you don't have to go through OSCE and the pencil and paper work here in DHA. The score that you get in DHA or HAD exam or any of these are valid for 5 years. This is a common point for all 4 examinations. Once you have passed DHA, the score will be valid for 5 years. Let's say you clear DHA exam, the score is valid for 5 years. Within those 5 years, you have to start your residency. The third examination that here is DHCC. This is the world's largest healthcare free zone. The Dubai Healthcare City Zone is the world's largest healthcare free zone. And the examination is conducted similarly as DHA and MOH. All these 3 exams have same steps, these 2. 70 MCQ in 2 hours, CBT exam, that is MCQ exam, and oral viva. These 2 points are common here as well as here. Fee for DHA is 3020 AED, that is dirhams. And for the DHCC, it is relatively cheaper, which is for doctor, it is 280, and for nurses, it is $220. Sorry, dirhams. Now, if you're confused between doctor and nurses, all these 4 examinations can be given by any health professional, that is nurses, physiotherapists, doctors, surgeon, anyone can give these exams. there will be one exam for all of them to get a license. The fees is different. Nurses have to pay relatively lower as compared to the doctors. Now the MOH exam, which is for the other five states of UAE, it is the cheapest examination. The fee is 100 dirhams. You can convert dirhams into dollars and Indian rupees if you wish to. So this was the main points about all the examinations. Now we'll talk about common points. The centers for all these examinations are internationally located among 78 countries. You can give it from all the like India, USA, UK, Australia, anywhere around the world. If you wish to get more information, I'll upload the website links in the description box below. But yes, the centers are internationally located. You don't need to go to UAE to give any of these exams. Second is you can work in Dubai healthcare system with DHA license. If you have cleared this examination, which is easier as compared to DHCC, you can still work in the healthcare city. You can convert your DHA into HAD license. I should not be pronouncing it as HAD, but okay, HAAD. As I told, HAD is tougher than DHA. So what most people do is they give this examination DHA and they convert their DHA license into HAAD, which has been started recently. So you can do that as well. Two steps will be less and it will be relatively easier for you. All these exams can be taken by any MBBS, BDS, physiotherapist, nurses. I told you about this point. It's common for all of them. You gotta renew your license every year. Okay, once you have done your MBBS, your internship, I'll tell you about the eligibility criteria. Once you have finished your MBBS, you gave these exams, any of them, then you'll get a license. And you should renew your license every year. Renew it within 3 months of the expiry. So this was about getting a license as to work as a general practitioner in UAE. The eligibility criteria, which I should have talked about first before talking about exams, but okay. The eligibility criteria to give the exams are, first one, you should have done your MBBS from a WHO certified university. Second one is internship of 1 year. And the third one is 2 years of experience. 2 years of experience is mandatory for all of us. The exemption from the exam, from any of these exams, is for people who have finished MRCP, MRCS, US Assembly Step 3, PLEB 2, New Zealand Examination, NZREX, and Canadian Examination, MCCQE. So you have done any of these exams, you will be exempted from giving these UAE examination, but you need to have 2 years of experience. This is mandatory. So let's say for my scenario, I've done my MBBS and I'm still doing my internship. So what if I want to go to UAE and work there as a junior doctor? I did my MBBS, I'm doing my internship, I'll wait for 2 years of experience and then I'll apply for any of these examinations. Or while you are doing your internship, you can do any of these examination and then wait for 2 years and go to UAE to get your job. So this was about the job in UAE. Now if you have cleared your examination, you'll apply for jobs in hospital and work as a general practitioner. The salary, the most important part of this video, is tax free. I have given some amounts here. Don't take it like specifically. If I've written 4 lakhs, don't consider it 4 lakhs. Let's say 3.5 to 4. So post MBBS, you'll get about 18,500 dirhams, which is 4 lakhs Indian rupees. Post MD, if you have done your MD and then you are going there, 33,500 dirhams and 7 lakh INR. Post MRCP, if you have done any of these examinations that I talked about, MRCP, MRCS, USMLE, PLEB, or any of those examinations, you'll get more than the MD guy. 48,000 dirhams, 10 lakh Indian rupees per month. Don't ask me in the comment if it's per month or per year, that's it. AED, if you are confused, is United Arab Emirates dirham, which is equal to 20 INR. So this is how you get a job in UAE. The next video will be, if you don't want to do the job and you just want to do your super specialization or specialization, that will be about residency in UAE. If you have any queries, please drop them down in the comment section below. Please share the video and subscribe to channel as it keeps me motivated to post more videos. So I hope I gave you an short preview about if you wish to go and work in UAE. Again, UAE, any of these examinations, you'll just get a license to work. That's it. Thank you so much for watching the video.